Hey, this is Nuno Bettencourt of Extreme, and you'll be watching Hot Guitarist Video Guitarist. Try it again. Yo, I know I'm talking with my mouth full, but this is Nuno Bettencourt of Extreme, and you'll be watching Hot Guitarist Video, and I'm spitting out nuts all over the place. What is that? Hey, this is Nuno Bettencourt of Extreme, and you'll be watching Hot Guitarist Video Magazine. Do you know?
All right.
Youngest of 10 kids in my family, I was lucky enough to go into one room and listen to the Beatles and go somewhere else and listen to, you know, Simon and Garfunkel or Zeppelin or Aerosmith. I had so many brothers and sisters that I, as opposed to just, you know, a person my age growing up in what is around me, I had the luck to just have everything. See, Eddie Van Halen's like a given. I don't think you even have to state. I think he pretty much made guitar playing this decade, or last decade, the way it was. He set the tone for it. So, Al DiMeola, a lot of stuff like Brian May from the Queen stuff. I usually listen to a lot of guitar players that are in bands also. A couple of people I'd love to really play with is probably Prince. I'd love to just to do something with someday. Someone recently I had met that I was always a big fan of her drumming was Sheila E. That I saw with Prince, and I think she's really talented as a drummer. Plus, she's gorgeous, by the way, if you didn't notice. And but that's not important. It's her talent that matters. Believe me. The only word there is extreme, you know, and that's why the name is there. You know what I mean? People always want to categorize you. Just like, I mean, it's very natural to listen to someone say, hey, you know, they're very this or they're very that. It's natural. But I think it's going to take a career. I think one of our goals is to just, you know, I mean, I don't compare us to Zeppelin or the Beatles or whatever, but when you think back in those bands, that's what they were. You can't put Zeppelin in any category, and you can't put, you know, I know it takes a career, but eventually we hope to just become extreme. Song, they can, first of all, it's quiet enough and not scary enough for radio stations to play. It's what we call MTV friendly, because Decadence can get the funk out warrant. It's just the way it is, you know. But at the same time, when we did this album, you know, people are like, are you upset that it's a ballad? It's not a ballad, it's a song.
just by saying I love you.
They felt that bad. They played their lighters. They got little anvil cases for the lighters and everything they take on tour with them. And you know, it's one of those things where we wanted the way things had. There's the way it is, and the way you know, the way you wish it was. And more than words is that video that did it. We wanted to incorporate the band obviously in any way. And usually they do mock us when we play the song anyway, so that worked out well. but as long as they're in there, and people know that this is a band thing.
Close your eyes and just reach out.
A month and a half ago, before we went to Europe, we were talking about a third record. Next thing we know, we get to Europe. 2 days into Europe, the record goes gold. The song is climbing up to, you know, it's a top 10 song, goes to number one. We find out it's on the verge of going platinum, and within a month, we're obviously very proud. We wanted this record especially to get heard, and that's what matters, the fact that it's going platinum. And as far as what it means to us, we haven't really seen it yet. You know, we're going back home to do the show, and we're getting the records handed to us, and maybe we'll get more of a sense of what's really happening. And to get like to the song to go to number one and see the Billboard, that's, there's no words to really explain that feeling. Probably the worst day of our lives. I think it's the biggest working day of our lives. I mean, you kind of get up at 7 or 8 o'clock and you start shooting. But it's actually all right. I think by the 40th or 50th take, it's still okay. But I think by the 80th, you've had it. You know what I mean? And it's really grueling. And the problem is you can't really lay off because you know they could use the end takes mostly, which they do a lot. So you got to always keep it up and keep it going through the whole day. The video is very one-dimensional. You know, and you're seeing this one view live, it's a different thing. You know, I think the band loves to perform, and it's just like, you just can't capture what you're seeing live on video. It's a shame that we're doing this tour, we don't really get to do what we really want to do. We're just trying to really fit a, you know, 80 pounds into a 60 pound bag kind of thing. We're doing edits and doing things here and there. But, you know, so hopefully when we get to a point where actually we have our stage and we have what we want to do, you're going to see Extreme as where it's really supposed to be at. Where we do what we can afford to bring a horn section along, where we can't afford to bring a piano along, where we can really afford to become us. But this, the cool thing about this is you're seeing Extreme as raw as it can be and just going out and kicking ass. A couple of companies had approached me to do some endorsements, and I didn't want to because I never used anything that anybody put out. Whenever I went to a store or bought some, I used to change it so much and cut it up and do all sorts of things to it. So they, you know, Washburn was the only one that said, well, you know, we don't want to force you to play anything, but what if we, you know, put out the guitar that you built? I love it. I mean, it took them a while back and forth, about 2 years to get it right, so I made sure I was in love with it. I'm using an ADA MP1 right now with the same power amp, and I'm using these old Ampeg speakers, the original V4 cabs, and just throw an ME5 rolling thing just for some delay, because, you know, live you need it. I've always liked people that just, instead of just favorite solos, I like people that just play solos that fit so well with songs that it's like a whole vibe you get. Like, for instance, the Hotel California, such a great song, and that solo itself, the solo thing, solo out could be a whole song of its own. You know, melody after melody after, it's just so memorable, and that's what I like, is just stuff that's memorable. There's times in songs to just go crazy, and there's times to just do things that just mellow out, you know. And I think I just respect guitar players that just play for the song. The notes have always been on the guitar, all the music has always been here. We're just discovering it, you know what I mean? And that's what it's about. Nobody should really take credit for inventing something or coming up with something, because you are what you eat. You didn't invent it. You have these influences when you're younger, and as you grow up, and you spit them out later in life, and that's pretty much how it is. And it's not science. You know, it's just a lot of it's creation, but it's in your own way. So if you have a lot of different things that you eat, you know what I mean, then you mix them up, and you know if you worship just one band, you're gonna sound like that one band. You know, if you're an Eddie Van Halen kind of worshiper, then that's what you're gonna be, just that. Say to any guitar player, if any advice is just be a musician and don't be just a guitar player. Because if you're just a guitar player, then you limit yourself. Even with your guitar playing, you can come up with so many things by listening to singers, by singing, by playing drums is important for any musician, because it's all related to time and grooves and, you know, being able to play with a band. So be a musician and don't be stupid. Go for the whole thing. You know what I mean? Don't just be a guitar head. You know what I want? I just want to be able to just do what I'm doing forever. You know what I mean? I don't think, I've always heard about people burning out and not, I can't imagine me doing that or the band doing that. I mean, I'm sure someday the band will get to a point where we'll slow down a little bit, but as far as doing things, I can't, some days I can't sleep at night because I got so much shit going through my head that I want to do, and things and songs and projects and so many people I love to work with that I think I think if I can just sustain, you know, being able to stay healthy and just do what I'm doing, I think that's all I want. This band and the people in it have a lot to offer, we feel, and a lot of new stuff and a lot of different things we want to do. And the second we get a chance to, you know, that's what this is about, the whole platinum thing and selling records. It's not about the money at all. I mean, everybody wants to be comfortable and have their houses and, you know, can eat well for once. But it's really about just staying around and playing, giving something back.